Mental. Absolutely mental.
And also with his style of play, so athletic. And at the highest levels of table tennis, it's hard to maintain your physical fitness. Of course, we spoke about how modern science has improved so much, giving so much data to these players for them to work on the physical aspect, but mentally as well. I mean, it'll be hard to be a Dmitry Ovcharov. As simple as that.
Two.
Touching upon what you said about Dima's athleticism, for me, there's no one more athletic than Calderano. I'm not just saying that because of the backflips that he can do in the handstand walks, but just his whole style. Slings it, bombs the ball. I mean, blurs the lines in a way. You don't think it's possible to hit the ball so hard from where he is. So direct, Calderano, unforgiving with the attacks. Ovcharov beat him in the quarterfinal of the Olympics in Tokyo. Never in a million years it catches the edge.
1-4.
Well, Ovcharov trying his best in this entire rally. The improvisation in the backhand was so good. But Ugo Calderano really proving why he's so athletic and a bit more fortunate versus the German.
The double hand, the backhand, everything. It's just one of the, you know, it makes Calderano so marketable. If you wanted to prove someone wrong who said table tennis is not a sport, you'd show them a match of Calderano, wouldn't you? The only thing about that is, well, how free is his style? And how free can your style be if, and this is something that he will want and hope to achieve, you want to be a world number one, like Dima has been. Because Calderano, with his shots, has every string needed in the bow. But how can he get the blend? We've talked about that before.
4-3.
How can he know? How can he decide when? Can he decide when? He needs to hold back a bit on certain shots and when he should go for the kill.
3-5.
Well, that backhand serve from Ovcharov, fun fact, it was included in 2008 by Times Magazine, one of the 50 most innovations of that year. It was the new ping pong serve, and they said it's not about the power, it's about the weirdness, how Ovcharov crouches to table level and then peers over his paddle and executes a hand dance before launching the ball at his opponent, who's probably dumbfounded to respond. But well, here Calderano has all the responses Ovcharov has to throw.
He's got a couple of iconic serves, Dima, hasn't he, with the forehand tomahawk and that knee drop serve, of course. But Calderano is a skyscraper, so high the toss.
But still just wondering how cool it is to have that sort of a title with you. How innovative a player can get. Dima, although still not finding his rhythm very well in this match. 6-point lead for Calderano.
He's trying the local league serve here, Dima. It's helped him beat great players when he's in the spots of bother. Just this simple service with the backhand, because he loves that backhand over the table.
5.
Because it's a less expensive stroke in terms of time. Serving with a backhand is a great idea. We see taller players being more backhand dominant on average. And that serve suits it down to the ground.
Ten.
How clean is that?
Five.
Bookmark it. Watch it again and again. Ugo Calderano with that big backhand. Look at how nicely he positions himself, stays so stable, and that wrist work along with a lot of power coming from the core and elbow.
It was like a Indiana Jones whip from Calderano, as was that
six
from Dima.
Damn.
We'll be trading blows the whole match. We knew that was going to happen.
Yeah, well, you wouldn't expect less from both of them.
I think this serve is working nicely. Calderano kind of feels a bit weird about it himself, because there's a bit of pressure against that serve. It's like, I don't want to mess this receiver up because it's such a simple serve. Top block. Oh, wow. Here we go. Oh, that's a cold finish from Calderano. It plays into the entitlement of a player. That's, and that's the best way I could maybe say it. Nice flick there from Ovcharov.
Too low.
Spinnier, slower and slightly more shallow shot there from Dmitry Ovcharov. Second point in a row. Good start here by the German.
We saw yet another
three
one.
Low.
Well, Apolloni was also doing it against Omar Asar, wasn't it?
I find it so amazing to see that in the men's game.
1-3.
Also, the grunting of Ovcharov. I mean, he's such a beast. He's just the presence on the table. It's so authoritative.
Yeah. Whew.
Just like Rafael Nadal of table tennis.
You know it's Dima. I mean, you can hear him before you can see him.
Yeah.
More often than not.
He's in immense pressure.
Two.
He did say out in an interview yesterday that for many others, getting a reward to win a medal is something. But for me, everyone expects me to be always winning a medal and being in top 3, 4, 5. It's hard to live up to those expectations.
4-2.
He's certainly a man on the mission.
4-3.
For me, he should play the Olympics in Paris. He's someone who has been the most reliable at that event. Ball's never had a great Olympics, when you think about it. Losing to Quadri Aruna in 2016.
Three.
Adrian Crisan. Blast from the past for you there. The Romanian in 2012. Ovcharov's done it again and again. When you think about the number of medals of a currently playing player, he's second to Marlon.
It's
Fang Jendong, of course.
3-6.
Only has the one.
But the difference is in the number of years he's been able to grab that many more medals.
Yeah.
3-6.
67% chicken shot winners.
But what plays a factor into that is the fact that he plays for Germany and not a country like China, where playing more than one is a miracle.
Six.
So much topspin in that one from Calderano. I mean, for Ovcharov to hit a top edge, because he was seated quite comfortable, did not really expect so much rotation in that ball.
Kicked up like a mule.
7-4.
Very different setup of the second game.
like the little glance received, four, the little shimmy eight. In the shoulders of Calderano, but Ovcharov there just had his eyes on the ball.
Yeah, just kind of managed with just brilliant wrist work from him, because he did not have the time to move his feet, but that long body, upper body, did the work.
4-8.
It was amazing how he played that. Had a bit of a net, but still awesome from Dima, the reaction there. Swats it like a fly, and it flies past Dmitry Ovcharov.
Well, that grunt from Dima was so loud, but well, what was Ugo thinking? He's not intimidated at all. He slapped it right there. Whoa, that hurt.
He clobbered it, didn't he?
Nine.
And Calderano
five.
Tried to play another backhand from the forehand side. Maybe Ovcharov using the peripheral there to play it into a position that Calderano wouldn't have been able to do it. Good from Dima.
Well, that backhand serve is really wondering, doing that difference in strategy for Ovcharov. Simple things making it work. And now 5 game points.
6-10. Let 6-10.
It, didn't it?
10.
Getting quite intense there.
Straight from the serve.
But if Ugo were to win this point, the serves with Dima, which has been working very well for him in this second game.
Ten. Eight.
Fully committed there, Ovcharov with a fantastic flick from the forehand side, though, and then, yeah, plays the exposed place.
It's wonderful to see how ready and alert and vigilant Calderano is. I mean, to really have an opponent like Dima, who's so aggressive with every single backhand and forehand that he makes, Ugo is not baffled at all.
Right off the bounce from Dima. Spurs again in the air, and he gets over the line there. Ovcharov. What a fantastic game two that was. Just a battle here of two sharks, two alpha predators at the very top of the non-Chinese food chain.
Really biting each other in every opportunity they get.
It's taking chunks, aren't they? Nice run into the body there off the loose ball from Ugo.
One, two.
Change in serve, though, from Calderano. Long serve to give him pace with which he could hit that backhand. Just unfortunate to not have it on the table. Fine margins in this game of table tennis.
Well,
3-1.
Unlike the flick where Calderano returned there, Ovcharov played the Chiquita. Not so much size been actually on that one, but it looked like a very difficult shot to do. We can forward Calderano.
Let.
But, and Dima is back with that. Getting a warning from the umpire.
3-1.
He wanted it higher, didn't he?
Yeah. So just.
That block. Something else. Been
one,
the shot of the year, and it's only January.
What a treat to watch for everyone who is watching. How agile, how athletic that could get, and so much power from off Chirhog.
2-4.
Do you think off Chirhog's grunts help him time the shot? Some tennis players have said that.
It totally does, because actually a lot of strength comes in from your core. And then when he grunts it out, it's almost like exerting all that pressure and bringing it in the speed and the spin in the ball. So the grunting will work only if you can time the ball well in that case, versus the players who don't grunt much.
One of the most distinct in the game.
Continuity of play, please. 3-4.
Minor adjustments in the receiving position of Ovtcharov. We made some big difference
there. Man, I just can't help but just applaud both these players. Really, this is an absolute treat and entertainment to watch.
Six, three.
And that's called strategy from Dmitry Ovtcharov. He did do that simple backhand serve, but not this time. He wanted a lot of rotation in it because he planned that flick.
That might be the best flick on the forehand I've ever seen Dima play. I barely ever see him play a forehand flick like that, to be honest. That was beautifully done. Still didn't really take away from how impressive it was.
Well, it did take some guts to attempt that. It was so quick and just bouncing on the ball. Look at that body positioning from Calderano.
Let 5-6.
Dismissive.
Oh.
Side swipes it and glides it right past Dmitry Ovtcharov there on that third ball attack. Don't forget the head-to-head. 3-1 to Dima. Their first meeting in 2014, their most recent April last year, which was
6-0.
The first and only time Calderano has beaten Dmitry Ovtcharov, and the most convincing between them that we've seen in terms of wins. 3-1.
And the first time Ovtcharov's top edge got hit with
time
those
out.
Spinny loops from Hugo Calderano. So interesting to see that.
Got it, 7-4. all.
That timeout really helped Dima to get his head get together and bring more calm and composure back in this game.
Leaping, jumping, binding, everything necessary to claw out that point there, Dmitry Otcharov. We know how rock solid he is. And it gets tough when it gets tight. He wants his rematch against Felix Lebrun. He wants his revenge, the German. Across the body from Calderano, the seatbelt shot.
Did not have enough space to make that one, but just created space by moving the upper body just a bit behind. It's quite crazy to see from where all, what all positioning Calderano is able to really get the balls back.
That anatomical contortion. In is so athletic, so athletic. And so
nine,
flexible.
Lovtcharov takes the lead there now. The second, the third, this game is so critical. Remember, it is a best of five match.
Let 9-8.
The ball did not have enough rotation in it. Ugo just went right on top of the bounce and gave everything back in the ball.
That's why I was so impressed with the forehand flick earlier. That he did from the backhand side. Why is he doing the backhand flick from the forehand side? He's obviously not usually so willing to do the forehand flick.
I'm sure he must be mad at himself for missing this one. It's right there for him. Imagine 9-9 and 8-10 is completely different scores.
Might have been just a mistake that Calderano needed.
And that Cholecho really shows that what Dima was hitting inside him. He was not happy with the previous mistake, but yes, this he will happily take. One game point for the German.
Ten.
What a flick. Stunning from Calderano to save the game point. Here it is. Creates the cave with the body. Oh.
And to me, it's so crazy to displace somebody as tall as Dima is.
That's a very good point.
Wonderful from Calderano.
How did he play a shot of reverse from there? Dima doesn't normally shout at himself, but in the heat, in the ecstasy of battle, couldn't help himself there from giving himself a telling off. Look at that.
It was almost a double-handed backhand from Ugo.
He's been playing them all week.
Yeah. Gosh. Oh, that grunt from Dima almost scolding himself. I can't sit on my seat anymore.
And there it is. Shot that's helped him beat Fan Zhendong three times. That bomber backhand. Clats it, Dima.
Oh, 11, 12.
It's just so good in these moments. It's the grit, the guile.
And also the ability, right? You wouldn't see any unforced errors from Dima at this stage of any match. Just shows how good he is in the early points, early stages of any point. and now leads by one game point. But well, so is to Calderano.
Ooh, that's clever from Calderano, isn't it?
And displaces Dima again because he went inside the table, thought that Calderano will keep it short, but that long push, yeah, that was quite aggressive.
Interestingly played as well.
Side spinning it.
Yeah. I really love that from Calderano there. Very unusual shot in a moment of that magnitude.
What a nail-biting match this is going.
They say a 12-all Dmitry Ovcharov.
13-12.
I think the initial spin was nice. He got a bit of passive play from Calderano, but then misses the trademark.
I think he got disbalanced with that first top spin. The body was just not stable for Dima in that point.
I think there was residual top spin from his own loop coming back at him.
Yeah. And now, first game point for Ugo.
Went for the kill there, didn't he?
But quite flashy. Wouldn't expect him to miss this one at this stage. Just, he did everything right in that point, but I think just went for more of an impact versus more rotation.
Here it is again. Local league serve.
14-13.
Calderano that time wasn't intimidated by it, by the prospect of missing it or doing something not good enough with it.
But that backhand wrist work was so good. The ball really dipped. Ovcharov had no strength to bring it out up from the net.
Taking
15-13, game to Calderano.
That was a marathon. That was a war. And he purges the first point.
One low.
Calderano not do. Look at that punch from right there, and the step from the left foot really helped him put in a lot of impact in that punch.
Golf two.
Having the same kind of effect as it was, so credit to Calderano for that. He's winning more of the medium length rallies now, seven of the last eight to the thrill from Brazil.
After a win there for a towel break, just forgot. It's just 3 points into this fourth game.
Four low.
Wow. This is quite crazy how Calderano has started this game. Considering what a thriller that third game was.
It's strange to see a 4-0 on the scoreboard, isn't it?
Yeah, how neck to neck this match has been, you wouldn't ever imagine.
Chained together in so many ways. A change to the more pendulum serve of Calderano with a bit more emphasis on producing side spin there. What do you think the difference maker's been that's led to this point, Neha?
I think just staying in the rallies and the ability to convert. He's played many more points with not much rotation in his forehand attacks. Ugo there. This one as well. It was loopy, but not really giving trajectory for Ovcharov to do anything.
6-2.
Is really the pressure building on Ovcharov. I really want to get inside his mind and ask him, what is he thinking right now? Because he spoke about pressure yesterday.
Mm. 7-2.
Well, at the moment, he's just showing he's got a few more strings to his bow than Dima in this particular match. It's been different before. But he's made sure it's been different today, Calderano. Yeah.
True.
Definitive.
Eight.
Destructive. Heat-seeking missile. Look at the exaggerated compound movement, how drastic that was to get in position for that winner. On the back foot.
3-8.
Dismisses the fact he even won that rally. Team is still a mountainous task to come back and deny Calderano the win. Oh, a punch.
8-4.
Taking a leaf out of Chris Morgard's book.
So thunderous from Ovcharov there, really went from the word go.
From Dima. It's clever when you're losing to just delay it a little bit longer in between points. Try and make your opponent impatient. Try and make them rush to finish.
Timeout.
Experience, and it's helped Dima here. Get to a position where the alarm bells are ringing for Calderano. 6-9 in the fourth. It's match point.
Ten,
it's four match
six.
Points to Ugo Calderano. He's done it.
11-6.
Pinpoint precision
match
by the Brazilian powerhouse.
Calderano.
Explosive. Explosive.